Hi, I'm Robert, and I'm a SCEC-UseIT intern. Today I'm going to show you how to use SCEC-VDO, an interactive tool developed by UseIT interns to help visualize georeference data, such as political boundaries, fault systems, and earthquake sequences.
Let's dive in. When you first open SCEC-VDO, a wizard appears and prompts you to either create a new project or open an existing project. If you don't want this window to appear again, just check the box next to the Never Show This Again message. Now we're going to create a new project. Type in the name of your file and click on Save. You can toggle the wizard by clicking on Help and scrolling down to the Toggle Wizard option. Looking back at the main screen, you will see several default tabs available. The Political Boundaries tab, Graticule tab, and Drawing Tools tab. SCEC-VDO also includes various plugins that open up a new tab to adjust their respective settings. These allow you to change visual settings in SCEC-VDO, such as adding geographic features, adjusting grid lines, and editing colors. Use the left mouse button to rotate the map, and the scroll wheel to zoom in and out. Alternatively, you can click on the zoom in and zoom out buttons on the toolbar. Now let's create a fun little video. In the Plugins tab, under Open SHA, select Earthquake Simulators. To display the faults in California, select the All Cal 2 catalog as your input. Click on the visible box next to the All Cal 2 catalog to display all the faults in the catalog. Voila! All the faults should now be displayed on your screen. It is color-coded based on slip rate. You can pause the video here to catch up. Go to the Render tab and select Timeline. This will open up a new window. Set an initial camera keyframe by clicking on the yellow rectangle. Now, let's zoom into the big bend of the San Andreas Fault. After this, double-click on the 5-second point. You can also turn off the visibility of a layer with the gray keyframes, and turn it back on with the blue keyframes. You can go to the render settings to adjust the length of the animation, select the type of file you want to export, and other options. We're going to set the animation's length to 10 seconds to shorten the render time. To view your animation, simply press the play button. To save your animation as video, click on the red record button, select where you want to save your video, and hit save. Once it finishes rendering, go to your selected location, and ta-da! You just completed your first SCEC-VDO animation. I hope you enjoyed this quick overview of SCEC-VDO. Be sure to explore all of the program's capabilities. For more information, read the user manual or visit our website.